Welcome back, guys. Today we're going to talk about how to become a beta tester. But first, we should establish what a beta tester actually is. So let's start off with that. So what is a beta tester? You may ask, and I may answer. Anyways, a beta tester is actually a group of external users who are given a final product to test before its final release. The group usually consists of a variety of different users with different backgrounds. They may be techies, they may be accountants, they may be, I don't know, I forgot, other professions. Anyways, it may be basically a variety of people from a variety of backgrounds and as well as different locations and other external factors that the product may need. During the testing, they give feedback, report bugs, and give their initial sort of report on what they think of the product, what they found, and so on and so on. This helps initially to get the product up to the user base needs and maybe some other improvements that, you know, the product can still sort of have or improve on before initial release, like the final release. So what are their responsibilities during this testing phase? So their initial sort of responsibilities are to do testing all around, report bugs, whatever they may find, provide UI and UX feedback on some improvements from behavioral parts or something that may not be clear for, you know, the end users, communicate with the developers, test the environment setup. Usually they use like test flight on iOS or maybe some other combinations. So that is an important point to test as well. And after all of that, they gather a report with everything that they've seen, tested, found, and yeah, initial basically report on what they think of the product. So how to actually become a beta tester now? The most important question, right? So first, you should probably learn the skills that testing actually requires. You should probably go and read through ISTQB, at least understand the fundamentals and what it means, what it actually does. And then I would advise to learn maybe more in depth of the beta testing itself, like setting up environments and what approaches you could actually use during your beta testing phase. Now, this could be through YouTube, through courses, through, I don't know, my videos, something like that. But yeah, learn the skills and use the resources that you have available everywhere. That would be the first. But then also learning by doing. You should probably play around with the existing apps, products, or anything really that you would want to test and just try to create your own example report of what it actually means and what steps you would go through. This would also be actually a great thing to share later when you're applying for jobs maybe. So yeah, this would help you learn fairly quickly by just doing it. So the next point would be to apply for beta tester positions. First, I would try to find the jobs out there that they already have, maybe looking for specifically beta testers. Then another way is through LinkedIn. You could find developers and ask if they or their company is looking for beta testers. Just reach out, make connections, and, you know, just open the door and be open to the possibilities that maybe at some point, if they do need, they can reach out to you. Also update your LinkedIn profile to show that you are a beta tester, open for, you know, freelance or whatever is another great point. If the developers are not searching for beta testers, maybe they can, you know, suggest someone who is or a company who is actively looking for. So just go out and ask. Maybe also create some posts on LinkedIn that you are looking for these possibilities. Then next thing I would try is also just Googling beta tester, I don't know, positions or offers, freelance work, whatever I could find, just to start getting my experience and up to speed of it. Then another place that I would probably look for is Reddit. I could create a post, ask, hey, do you know anywhere where I could apply or look for positions as a beta tester? I'm very interested in it. And, you know, just create posts in different groups. There is a bunch of them that you can try out. You can just search in Reddit. Then there's another option to actually join already existing beta testing programs. Those would be like TestBird, Beta Testing, Test.io, and then the freelance ones like Upwork and Fiverr, from which you could actually get a long-term gigs. It's just you have to sort of build up your profile. So these are the places that I would try out and, you know, sign up for and be open to possibilities that they have. And yeah, just start out slowly with these as well. And yeah, on Fiverr and Upwork, like I could create my profile, add all of the information, just apply to different gigs. Maybe they could turn into a long-term position, and or maybe they could just, you know, use me whenever they need as a freelancer. There's a lot of possibilities on these platforms. Now that we have put ourselves out there, like be open to these positions, you know, the last question that I actually had, are beta testers even paid to do their work? And there's two sides to this, which I haven't seen people talk about. Yeah, so in some cases, you are actually not paid for your work, which you should actually establish before you start the gig. Of course, if you're trying to just gain some experience, it may be beneficial to do this once or twice, just to, you know, have something to show for yourself and to share later on. But depends, like, how much work. Are we talking about one-time thing, or like you, there's like multiple hours or weeks that you will need to be involved. So take this in mind when you're applying, and also read the disclaimers and everything that job applications have in mind. And then of course there's the second one, where of course you are paid, but sometimes it can be in gift cards, or maybe they are trying to give you some premium features that they have for their product, or sometimes they do pay you. So there's like three ways that they can pay you: gift cards, just regular pay, and some premium features from the product. Look out for the options, but written in descriptions. Just thought it would be good to tell you this, guys. But overall, if we're looking for the average pay statistics in the US, the pay is actually the pay grade in US on average is from 44,000 to 84,000. So on average, that would be 62K. Statistically, that's how much beta testers get paid. But obviously these are like set positions, long-term, how do you call them? Full-time positions. These stats are from those, not from gigs. But obviously there are statistics out there and they pay very well. So, you know, you just have to put yourself out there. Okay, that is basically it.
Yo guys, thank you so much for subscribing. This is a great milestone, and yeah, thank you so much.